everybody, and welcome back to another Christmas DIY video. My name is Angeline, and I am the owner of Angelic Creations. So let's go ahead and get started with today's project. Hey guys, so we are now in Cricut Design Space, and please bear with me, I am using one hand. So I'm going to create some hair ties for my nieces for Christmas, but I'm going to show you how I created my card holder first, okay? So we're going to go over here to shapes. We're going to click on this rectangle shape here with the rounded edges. And then I'm going to go back into shape, and I want to click on the square. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to unlock this shape here by going up to the unlock tool here. And I'm going to shape it about maybe there. I'm not really going to be exact, but that's fine. And I'm also going to do the same thing for the square. Just giving you all an idea. Okay, so now that I have these two positioned there, I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this top one. And I'm going to place it at the bottom. Now I want to make sure that my sides are even. So what I usually do is pull up my grid. So I go ahead and highlight them all. I pull them over to the side to make sure they all meet. And actually, it's perfect. I don't need to do anything. You see, it's a straight line here. So the next thing we're going to go over here and do, while it's all still highlighted, we're going to go over here to combine right at the bottom. And then we're going to click on weld. And once you click on weld, now you have one solid piece here. Okay, now the next thing I'm going to show you is how I created the Merry Christmas with the cutout. So you're going to go over here to text. You're going to type in whatever text you would like. I'm just going to do Mary for this one. Just to give you all an idea. So just type in Mary. Okay. And we're going to go over here to combine again. And we're going to weld these pieces together as well. And now you don't have that funny cutout line that we just saw before. It's all one piece. So we're going to go ahead and minimize it about there, I would say. Yes. Now you want to go ahead and highlight these two pieces together. Sorry. Okay. Now that it's highlighted, you want to go over here to your right-hand side, and you're going to click on slice. And once you click on slice, now you have your Merry cutout. Okay, so that's one example. And the next example I will show you all is how to place it on top. Okay guys, so I went back in, I changed my font, and I changed my words. So these are both my niece's names. As you can see, the top one, Azaria, it fits perfectly on top of the template. My niece, Royalty, hers is gonna look a little funny, and I'll show you why. So when I move Azaria name out the way, you have to make sure that the letters are touching the top of the template. As you can see, her name has two Y's in it, so those will be cut off. So it wouldn't work correctly. So for hers, we will have to do something different. But I'll show you with this name how it fits on there. Very perfect and smooth. So just making sure that each letter is touching the top just a little bit. So now what you want to do is highlight both of these together. You're going to go over here to combine, and then you're going to click on weld. Okay, so you see how that worked perfectly? Like, you can still see every letter is very legible. If I would have did royalties, it would have been cut off. So yeah, that's that one. And the last example you can do is you can take your, let me move these out of the way. Bring this one over. And I'm just going to pull Mary back up real quick. Place it there. And then you can go over here to the operations section. And you can click on a pin. It's going to write out Mary for you. So you just, what you would do is you would click on both of these. And you would click, you would place them on top of each other, sorry. You will highlight them both, and then you want to click on attach, which is at the bottom right. And once you attach them, first thing that the Cricut machine is going to do is going to pin out Mary, and then it's going to cut the template. Okay? So you have this one, you have this one, and you also have this cut out here. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and cut out the ones that I want to choose. Okay guys, so my pieces have been cut out. I chose to cut this one out with the gold on the back. Then I place some double-sided adhesive on both pieces. And then I'm just going to place this on top. Okay. And this is how this one turned out. All right, now this is the foldable elastic that I'm using. I purchased this from another small business owner. I just tied in the knot, but before I tied them in a knot, I did cut them using these scissors right here, the pinkish scissors. And then I used a highlight to just seal in the frayed edges, the frayed ends, I'm sorry, right here. I'm not sure if it's gonna fray or not. It's my first time using them, but I just wanted to be safe. Never know. So here I am just placing them on the card. Like so. So a total of 3 fits perfectly. That's fine. I have a total of maybe 15 or 18 different prints. So I'm going to make them a couple of more. But for right now, this is the completed look. And I made a smaller one. Maybe for like my smaller niece, the ones that's like maybe 8 and 5, maybe I'll just cut the elastic out maybe 8 inches long. But these are for my bigger girls. These are 10 inches long. So this is the larger one and this is the smaller one. And this one is for, oh, this one is 4x4, and this one is, I believe, 4x3.5. yes, 4x4, and this is 3.5x4, and 3.5 is the width of this 4. Okay guys, so that is the end of the video. If you have any questions, make sure you leave them down in the comment section below. If you like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you love the video, make sure you share it with your family and friends. Stay tuned, we do have plenty more Christmas DIY videos coming soon. Bye.